Okay, is this your marching order, like this?
I think so.
Yeah.
Unless Patron wants to go in the back, but I don't think anything's okay. Coming up behind
us. Well, where
us.
You want me? I try to be where I could get heals in on you guys.
I think that works.
All right.
Unless that dragon's going to come back and get us, I think it's fine to have those guys in the back.
So
I've got better defenses than Zardus, I think.
Go ahead and roll.
Yeah, guys. I think we would have put those bones of the dragon in the fire.
Okay, fair. Yeah.
What are we rolling?
The dragon is cinders now. And in fact, you find some shiny scales. You each have 5 shiny scales.
5 shiny scales.
And roll me perception.
There's going to be a nat 20. Just watch it. 15. Good enough, anyway.
Okay, you're all well enough to hear it. You both hear the shattering scream of 2 children. Even the one hears it.
Okay.
And go ahead and position yourselves within the first few squares of the room. All right. You can clearly see the drow woman. You recognize her very obviously. And next to her is this demonic aberration. He looks to be assembled from 2 or 3 different bodies, but upon closer inspection, it's very clear that he's actually composed of 2 children.
Oh, man.
And you hear him speak. Oh, it feels good to be back at last. It's been so long. The woman speaks. The master has been patient. We've awaited your return a very long time. And they suddenly both notice you coming. And she screams, "Who the hell are you? How dare you interrupt this holy of holiest moments?"
There's holiest nothing moment. Holy about that abomination.
The abomination. He laughs at the sound of the word. And he says, "Vraska, I'll leave you to deal with this." And he basically just kind of folds in on himself. Like there's tentacles throughout his body, and he folds in on himself and disappears.
Zardus is noticeably shaken and as pale as a sheet.
Paler than being dead already.
Super pale.
It probably doesn't have pallor yet.
She moves up to here, and it's weird that Zardus got back up, but none of you actually inquired about it.
I don't have a soul right now either. It doesn't seem like that big of a deal, really. So.
Yeah, this is a weird crypt. This is a strange place. Anyway,
for all I know, the heal check worked.
She turns to you all, and she says, "Oh, I remember you. You were all in that bar. Ah, the dwarf out front, you look very familiar. I think I've met some relatives of yours before." Again, she laughs. It's up to you to respond in whatever way you want.
I'm probably going to just charge straight at her. I don't think he's got time for words after that. So.
I don't think you'll make the distance.
I don't think I will either, but...
You can go ahead and charge if you, or start closing towards her.
5. No, I should be able to get a charge. I'll do a move and a charge. So.
Okay, well, we haven't rolled initiative.
Well,
yet,
I know.
So I'm not sure I'm gonna let you
we'll
that.
See how close I get anyway.
You can start moving towards her if you like.
I'll move up. That's as far as my movement will take me. But.
Okay, so before rolling initiative, she clearly. She becomes very defensive, and she says, "Oh, we're going to do this then. Fine." And the sarcophagi in front of you, they all burst open, and you see, I hate Sorry. They burst open. And shambling corpses walk out, clearly under her command.
Great.
Oops. And go ahead and roll me initiative.
Come on high. Oh, shit.
So we get a plus two from somebody, right? Yeah.
Yeah, you guys all get plus two.
Woo! So I finally got a good roll.
Nice.
Too bad it's not an attack roll.
Alright, I've actually got the 22 then.
John, you've got the 22.
Yep.
Patrons, 16.
Yep.
Okay, and Chris has also got a 22. Very nice. Alright, I'll roll initiative and I'll be right back with you guys once I have it. Alright, so... Can someone read that for me? I can't right now.
Is this a new encounter for powers?
Yeah, it should be. We all healed.
Yeah, it's a new encounter.
Plus you got, Zardus, you got like full rest.
Yep. Everything but levels.
So you got your daily back even.
I never spend it, so.
I bet you wish you did now.
So. Yeah, no, I think it wasn't like totally broken, so. Otherwise I would have said he wouldn't have had his daily.
Oh, there we go.
Wow. Very nice, guys. You did really well on this initiative.
Except for Zardus, who's apparently scared shitless.
Yeah, he's taken aback.
He did soil himself before.
You know, as
so.
Bad as his role was, it's not the slowest. I rolled it at one.
Oh, wow.
I hope it was the boss lady there.
No.
Remembering that Zardus takes a few sniffs and looks over at Patron. What the hell stinks?
You can check yourself later. We got stuff to do.
God, that's disgusting. All right. As good as your rolls were, you didn't beat them.
No. Mm.
The shambling corpse will move up to John, and he will make an attack. Tell me if does a 19 hit your AC?
Yeah, it does.
Take 4 damage. And Chris.
C. Are you attacking me?
No, it's your go.
Oh. Oh. Sorry.
Sorry.
Is that a suit of armor?
It is.
Okay. Just checking. Well, let's start off things with a bolt of chaos energy. 15. That one, I'm going to add a 1, so it's a 16.
16 versus what?
Will.
Oh, yeah. Your macro says that, eh? Sorry.
Yeah.
Yep, that hits.
All right. 15 damage, and...
He vaporizes.
Ew. 7 versus Will.
That will miss.
Alrighty. And... I will pass my turn.
All right. It is John.
Yep. All right. I'm going to hack and hew at the two guys right next to me here.
Okay. Who are you targeting first?
We'll do the one standing on the crypt first.
Sure.
Actually, I will move right there. It's okay.
Yeah, that's fine.
Are those torches coming out of the walls or what?
They're standing out through the ground, but they're so thin you can literally just like walk around them.
Okay, all right.
Good point.
Let's see. Was that enough to get me drunk for that
Oh yeah, you're wasted.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure.
Versus
AC. I think I only have one thing that targets anything besides AC. So.
Yeah, that's good.
Okay.
Wow. Very nice.
So, I'm guessing
you.
Go ahead.
You take off both of its legs.
Okay.
But it is still menacingly glaring at you.
All right. And that is against the other one, which I'm going to guess is a miss.
That's a miss, yeah.
Okay. And I will mark both of them.
Okay, yeah. Patron.
All right. Those guys are still up or bloodied or what?
They're bloodied.
Yeah, the one that was hit is bloodied.
Yeah, this is the one I hit. And the other one I missed. So.
I'm just letting you guys know that I am sending you messages in Skype once in a while.
Oh.
And that's kind
of... Oh, I have to check.
Yeah. It's fine. Nothing has been missed. But if you hear the Skype ring, it might be me talking to you. So you might just want to check in once in a while.
Okay. If I don't respond,
how do you,
let me know.
Check that.
If you click on Skype, there should be a...
Yeah, I don't know how to check
recent.
That.
There should be a button that says recent.
Mm-hmm.
And then you'll see like the number one. If someone has sent you a message recently, you just click on their name and you can read the new message.
Oh,
so okay.
Peter knows how to do it.
I found it.
Excellent.
It took me a little while. Alright. I don't know why you moved up there, but I am going to move here.
Okay, sure.
Actually, hold on a sec. I'm trying to hear if I can.
Yeah, you should be able to do that.
And I want to... I don't know what this is going to hit. I want to use my breath weapon.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure it hits reflex because it's a blast.
No, what I mean is, like, who is going to be in my blast?
How big is it?
It's a close burst 3.
Okay, so...
Those two.
Yeah, basically... All right,
I'll give that a...
Where are you targeting it, sorry?
I guess this ack. This.
Yeah, okay, yeah, that would work. So basically you're hitting this area.
Yeah, my screen went completely blue here. The map.
Interesting.
Okay, now it's fine. The screen went temporarily completely blue.
It was nothing that I did.
Okay, that's only going to be a 10.
You roll individually. Reach? Yeah, you roll individually. So I'll say that was the closest guy to you.
All right. And then 13.
And that's targeting their
reflex.
Yeah, that hits.
Okay. Seven.
Okay. He's shaken, but still glaring menacingly at Slayton.
And I'll end there.
Okay. It is Vraska's turn.
Wait, don't you have a standard?
The breath is...
Well, oh, wait, that's right. That was only a minor, my breath.
Oh, I thought it would hit all four of them, your breath weapon.
No, it's only in a three.
Okay.
Well, I didn't want to hit my allies, so...
Oh, I see.
Yeah. All right, since I got a standard, I will... Kunanoko, they're going to hit you if you try to do something, right?
Oh, good point.
Yeah, the guy right next to him will kind of diagonally. All right,
I'm gonna give Sladen the action for him to go.
Okay. You know what? He should have gotten an opportunity attack. Is it cool if I just move back? Because I should have thought about that.
Yeah, that sounds fine.
Okay. Ew.
Well, then I would have been able to hit all three, I think, but that's all right.
Yeah, I'll just leave it as
is. I'm gonna give Sladen the go.
Okay. And what can I use? Just a melee basic or anything?
Yeah, just a melee basic.
Yep.
Yep.
And
that's against AC, yeah.
Yeah, I'll make it against this guy again. So.
Yeah, that hits.
Awesome.
They've been in there a long time. Oh my god. Okay, that skeleton's bones turn to dust, and as the robes fall back down onto the crypt, you see the emblem that was on top of the crypt is on a gold chain of his, and it lands on top of his shirt.
All right.
Or on top of the robes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that's patron's end of turn, so Vraska. Okay, she will use her Deathly Summons. It's an Area Burst 2, and this is targeting Fortitude. So she's going to... Yeah, she's going to target Zardus and Kona. No, it's only 2. No, she's going to target Sladen.
Okay.
Will it hit her own guys?
Yes, it will. Oh, wait. Yeah, in that case...
If you put it right there, you can hit both of us.
No, because it's only a burst 2.
But the burst stretches from there to there.
Oh, I see. So
yeah, it's two squares in each direction, yeah.
Oh, I hate the even ones, then. Okay, that's fair. So what I'll do in that case... So I can place it here and hit both Patron and Kononoko?
Can't you put it
and,
right there?
And your two guys.
Yeah, she doesn't really care about the two guys.
Well, if you put it right here, wouldn't it hit Zardus, Kononoko, and Patron?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Stop so giving him help.
Thank you. I'm learning this game.
Or right there, too.
Okay, so I'll target Patron first. 10. That's against Fort.
That's a miss.
Yeah. Zardus. 21.
Yep.
And Kononoko, 10. Oh my god, Zardus, you just got kicked on. All right, Zardus.
At least Zardus had his healing charges.
Yeah. That's almost why I did it. Zardus, you take 10 points of damage, and you are slid there.
All right. That puts me at 13. Which, is that bloodied yet? No, not quite.
And she will then move 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, she'll move right there. And she ends her turn. It is now... his piece off. It is now this fellow's turn. He's going to move over here and take an attack against Sladen.
Okay.
So this is going to be versus your AC. Does a 13 hit your AC? I don't think it does.
No, sorry,
not 13. It's 15.
15. Did we change the drunk to give me a minus 2?
It gives you a minus 2 to everything but your AC.
Everything? Okay, then no, it doesn't.
Okay. So he will end his turn there.
I hate to be that guy, but wouldn't it be better to go into flanking?
It would. But I also know...
They are undead, so...
Yeah.
I also know the initiative order. And he can't really get there without taking any pass next to Sladen anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's blocking?
Yeah, it's there's steps up, and then this here is... Sorry, this here is impassable terrain.
Ah. Okie dokie.
Yeah, I have to make that more clear. He's going to move to where the skeleton used to be, basically standing on top of the robes, and make an attack against Sladen again.
Yep.
12. Yeah, 12. No.
Woo-hoo!
He ends his turn and misses Zardus.
I'll just go ahead and make quick potty. You think I should try to get her closer to us, or should we just let her stay down there?
Don't let her run away.
Okay. If I run to here, will she be within 10 squares of me? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Yeah.
Yeah, she will.
Okay. I will use Charm of Misplaced Wrath, and it will be versus her will. Yeah. Come on, Das. Oh, not bad. 17 versus Will.
That hits.
Okay.
You should probably go, like...
I slide her 3 squares, so I guess right there.
Okay.
She is dazed until the end of my next turn.
Okay.
And she will also make a free action to make a basic attack against herself of a plus 2 damage to the roll.
Okay.
Plus to the roll? Damage roll.
Damage okay, roll. Damage. Okay.
Yeah.
she misses herself.
I'll burn a...
action point?
Do we have our action points back?
You do.
I'll burn my action point and,
You'll heal too, then.
Max. Oh, how much do I get back?
You'll heal 2, since you're down. You're down 10,
I think. Yeah. So, alright, that takes me back to 15. Let me just put that in real quick. Okay. And then I will try to hypnotize her.
Sure.
Then I will take a minor action because I'm going to start learning from my mistakes. And I'm going to use my void assumption, and I'm basically just taken off the board of the map until the beginning of my next turn.
So that's right.
That is void assumption. You cease to exist and take no actions until the start of your next turn. You have line of sight. They don't have no line of sight. And then I can do it when 3 squares are here. I can kind of instant teleport.
Very nice.
It was that thing I used to get to the priest last time. I kind of faded away.
Oh, right. Yeah, that was pretty cool.
So he's not there. I don't know how to put him there. But.
Okay. Fair enough. This guy will go.
You could change his color to purple or something.
Yeah. I don't know if that works with the circle token.
No, you have to go into like your customize and then change your tint color.
No, I mean with the...
Oh, right. Very good.
Like that.
Yeah, like that.
Oh, nice.
And this guy will take an attack versus patron. So patron, let me know if. Let me know if I'm gonna, yeah. So 12 hits your AC. Jeez.
No, not doesn't.
No, I didn't think so. He's gonna look disappointed at just his turn there. Oh, he's still not dead.
Hey, buddy, we know how it feels.
So the guy who's marked by Sladen's going to take an attack against him.
Yep.
And tell me if 21 hits your AC.
Yep, that'll hit.
Take 4 damage.
All right.
He's like the only one who can hit.
I still have 2 temporary HP left.
And he ends his turn. It is Kononoko's turn.
All right, I'm going to move right there. And on that guy.
Against his will.
Nice, an even number.
That will hit. Yep.
Ooh, and actually, you know what? No. Bah.
Oh, sorry, the 16 is already the damage, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, my bad. So he gets vaporized.
Boom.
Awesome. Oh, and the guy on the tomb, I don't. He's not marked. It's the guy under him who's dead who still has that mark on him.
And because it's even, do you get like an additional attack? Or
the attack was actually odd.
Oh, okay. Oh, you're right. Yeah, the 19. Okay.
I will curse him.
Okay. You done?
Yep.
John.
Okay. I will... Let's see. Is any...
Did this guy go down?
Yeah, did...
Yeah, he's down. Yeah.
Sorry. Yeah, it is... Are any of the, are either of these other two guys injured?
They are full health. Both.
Full health. All right, I will. I'm already lined up on that tomb there. I'll target that guy with a brass strike.
Okay.
13 versus AC.
Miss.
Miss. Okay. And guess I will. Shift up to there.
Oh, I will use Adept Insight.
On his earlier attack?
The one he just rolled, the 13. Okay.
Yeah. That now hits.
Awesome.
So I'll just move you back there.
Yeah.
Don't bother rolling damage. He again, crumbles at the weight of your hammer. His robes and bones turn to dust. His bones turn to dust again, and his robes cover the emblem of the crypt, which were on the other guy's robes.
Mm-hmm.
You can all clearly see this.
Except me, because I'm not here.
And...
Right.
Can I shift up onto that tomb, or is that going to be too much of a move to jump up on top of that?
No, you should be able to.
Alright. I'll do that then.
It's awkward.
Yeah.
You're standing on two bodies.
Yeah, it can't be good footing.
Well, no, it's more like if you've seen War of the Worlds, it's like dust and clothes on top of it.
Ah, okay.
Is that your turn?
Yeah, that'll be... I don't have a mine or anything I can use.
Okay, Peter.
Okay, I am going to do a minor... Well, no, Zardus isn't even visible, right?
No, he's not.
Yeah, he's just gone.
Oh, damn it. All right. I would have done a heal on you. Sorry, man.
Oh, sorry. I just didn't want to get hit by another burst.
I understand. I perfectly understand. I'm gonna give Kononoko a go as my standard.
Okay.
Ew.
Well, it's a 19 to hit, but...
Yeah.
Are you hitting the cursed one?
Yeah.
19 to hit? Yeah.
You also get plus two.
All right, 10 to damage.
10? Yeah, it hits him. He takes the hit like a champ.
And then, as a minor, I'm going to use an inspiring word on Sladen.
That's a waste. I'm only down by two. So.
You're doing good. Oh, all right.
I said that last hit didn't do any damage because I had temporary HP, so...
Alright, hold on one sec.
Patron says, feel better. And
temporary HP goes away at the end of an encounter, but...
Yeah.
Yeah, I still have that guy from when I took him down.
Oh, okay. I didn't know you get that.
Yeah, I get anytime I hit... Anytime I hit an enemy, I get plus three. Anytime I use an invigorating attack, I get three, and if I do both, I get six, so...
Okay, so should you currently be at three?
Yeah, because I just killed this one guy. I was down to two, and I'm back up to three.
Cool. So, Patron?
I am going to shift over here.
Yep.
And I already gave my standard attack, so I'm going to reserve my minor. Nobody's in view, and Sladen looks like he's healthy, so I'll stay there.
Okay. Vraska. She's going to use Ray of Enfeeblement on Sladen.
Okay.
So that will be against your Fortitude 20.
Yep, that's going to hit.
Okay. That is 9 necrotic damage. And you are weakened until the end of Vraska's next turn. And weakened, if I remember, is you take a minus two.
Half damage.
Yeah.
Half damage.
Okay, nice. And she laughs and she says, oh, I haven't had this much fun in such a long time. It reminds me of the old war.
Slayton's going to yell back at her. You won't be having fun for much longer.
Oh, everybody's time comes eventually.
So I'm guessing Sladen seems to wrinkle visibly.
Yeah, he's obviously his muscles have lost definition. It's almost as if he's now 80 years old. Actually, he's probably already. He's now almost 100 years old.
Yeah, I say he's almost 70. So.
The skeleton just in front of you is going to make an attack. Oh, wait, no, sorry. She's going to move towards the door again.
She's dazed.
Oh, she is dazed. She can only make one action. Save ends?
No, just till the end of my next turn.
Oh, okay. So, yeah, the skeleton's just going to attack.
Yep.
Tell me if... 14 does not hit your AC.
Nope.
All right. Brad. Oh, wait, no, sorry. The other guy is going to attack Patron. Oh, wait, you know what? No, he can shift over to Sladen and attack Sladen. Yeah, that's what he will do.
Yep.
And Sladen, tell me if... I won't even ask. It doesn't. Okay, now it is Brad's turn.
And I believe if I appear over here, I will still be within 10 squares of her, right?
It should be 9.
Yes, you will.
Yeah. Okay.
I will then try to hypnotize her again.
Okay.
That's not going to hit, probably. That's, it's versus will. Yeah.
Yeah, no, it won't.
Then I'll burn my encounter a magic missile for 6 damage.
On her?
Yes.
She looks at you and is visibly annoyed. But then there's an instant where she looks at you softly and caringly. But then back to annoyed.
Zaldis is going to seem a little disshaken with that, and he is going to move right here.
Okay, I assume you read my note?
Note. Let me check 1 second.
The one in your journal?
Yes. So okay. He's having a pretty bad day right now.
Okay, good. All right. So that was Brad. Chris, it is your turn.
Seriously. All right, then.
Wow. I take it that's the guy right in front of you?
Yeah.
It hits him. You blast a hole through one part of his chest, but he's still standing.
Yeah.
Is he bloodied?
Oh, yeah. He's. If skeletons had blood, he'd be covered in.
I was just a little bit miffed that I didn't get an even number again. Wait. No, never mind. Can't take it back. I'll still move there, though.
Okay.
And I will curse her.
John.
I can't get any closer, really. So I'm going to... I'm going to brash strike the guy in front of me.
Okay. Roll me 2 hits.
The guy behind you is bloody too, though.
Yeah, I know, but he's going after her. I've been trying to make my way towards her this whole fight, but she keeps putting stupid skeletons in my way. So...
Oh, that hits.
Yes.
He vaporizes. And these are very old skeletons.
Yep. And I'm going to shift to here.
She's clearly nervous that you guys are now getting closer to her and her minions are gone, but she still has this confidence you're not able to account for. And Peter.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Ooh. Wait, you're moving. Where were you before?
Here.
Okay, yeah, you're fine then.
And I am going to give Sladen a go, because he has this thing against Drow.
Yeah, but I can't get to her, I don't think. I don't have enough room to charge, do I?
No, you have to be direct at her.
Yeah. So I can't do anything.
Okay, then Kononoko, you could go.
I grab you as you pass by me and try to get you to stay back a little bit.
So you've grabbed him here. It's up to him whether or not he wants to stay back.
Yeah.
Okay, if he seems to have a plan, I'll go with that.
Okay.
Give him a kind of odd look, but...
Ugh.
Yeah, that misses.
Wow, that was just bad all around.
I think that's the end of your turn, Patron.
Yeah, Zardus is out. He's not within 5 of me, is he?
No.
1.
Just out. All right. 3, 4.
Yeah. Shouldn't have shifted.
All right, Brass.
All right. Yeah, I think that's it for me.
Okay. She does not recharge. She will use Ray of Enfeeblement on Kononoko. And, sorry. Okay, so Sladen, you're no longer weakened, so she's going to use it on you again.
Okay.
So tell me if 24 hits your fortitude.
Yep, that'll do it.
She rolls good. And you take 8 necrotic damage and are weakened until her next
turn. DM hacks.
Yep. She can now move. She'll move there. She does get a +8 to that attack, so.
Yeah, that helps, usually.
So. Yeah, it sure does. Okay, it is now this last forgotten skeleton's turn. No one cares about him. He's going to shift here and attack Slayton. You really pissed her off.
Yeah.
That's a 13 versus AC.
Yeah, no, that's not going to hit.
I think only one skeleton hit.
One skeleton hit, but it didn't do anything to me. So.
Great. He will end his turn there, again, looking pathetic. It is now Brad.
All right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And while he is running, he is going to be yelling out in deep speech, and I guess I'll send it to you and your Scott thing.
Okay.
He's kind of foaming at the mouth. His eyes are shaking wildly, and he's kind of just breaking the wizard roll and kind of just madly charging forward. And he is going to cast a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. He's going to cast a freezing burst right there.
Okay.
Versus reflex.
That hits.
And 6, 8. For 11 cold damage.
Okay.
And going to slide her right up there.
Yep. All right. And you hear, as you shout that, just before your blast explodes in her face, oh, that sounded awful. she says, "Your mother is happy. She's with us." And she says that, and you see long fangs protrude as she puts a very fake smile on.
He looks like he's even more disshooken and ends his turn.
All right, it is Chris.
All right.
Use an encounter.
I'm using an encounter.
Don't miss.
Don't miss.
Says the DM. Versus that misses. Sorry, the 16? Yeah, that hits.
Yeah.
I was looking.
It was like Gerb.
It almost misses.
Right. So we add 7 damage to that, so 19.
Oh my god. Was that?
Yeah. Oh wait, 6. 6 damage. So 18.
Oh, okay. Alright, she is clearly bloodied. That blast goes right through her stomach.
Ouchie.
And anyone else?
Does it have any effect?
Yep. She takes a -2 to attacks until the end of my next turn.
Awesome.
Oh, good.
Ignore that. It's not real.
Oh, wait. I'm sorry. And same damage.
sorry, I'm just trying to figure out how I can do this.
Oh, what, did you target the other guy?
There we go.
No. I rolled the wrong damage dice.
Oh.
So that's a second attack, dealing 9?
No.
Okay.
The same damage. Okay. Nothing different.
All right. John, you might have the satisfaction of...
Yep. Let's see. I'm going to, I think, shift to here, and then charger.
Okay. Go ahead and roll me attack.
Good roll.
Go ahead, roll me damage. Nice.
And I'm going to tack on my Iron Wolf charge again, so give me an extra 1d6.
Okay. Tell you how much overkill you get.
Well, I am weakened, so that gives me...
I guess that gives you reason to use it.
Yeah. 19 damage.
So you deal her 9?
Yeah, it should be 9.
So that's 6 overkill.
Yes.
You hit her, she gasps and collapses. She's still breathing. But she's clearly not a threat any longer. However, as she does that, she makes an attack against you.
Okay. And Sladen's going to let out like a howl as he's made that attack.
Okay. So. Well, tell me if 19 hits your AC.
Yep. Finally. Okay.
You take 12 necrotic damage. As she collapses. But then that was the last of her energy. She's just slumped there, breathing very heavily. Oh, and the other skeleton is still alive.
Does he fall down?
Yeah, he collapses instantly. Thank you, though, for reminding me.
I was just curious if that would have happened.
Yep. It certainly does. And in fact, the two torches on her dais go out.
Oh, interesting.
Okay. That one gets really big for a second. And then it goes up. And you are now out of initiative. You have a dying drow woman in front of you who you all know as Raska, and you have a room with a bunch of dead skeletons, which I'm now going to just remove since they're kind of cluttering the board.
Zardus, Kononoko, can you figure out how to undo what she did?
I don't think there's any undoing killing those children, sadly.
Roll me a perception check.
Got an 18.
Is that everybody?
18. Yeah, everybody. Good. All right, so you can all clearly see the altar. You see that there's two what look to be slabs where someone was laid down. There's a lot of blood near where the heads would have been. And there's some child-sized bones in that center pit. And at the same time, she laughs and she says, "You cannot undo the beguiler's work." She says it very pain.
We'll just have to undo the beguiler then.
She laughs. She says, "If you kill me, I'll only return stronger. I'm sure you saw my friend."
He didn't appear to be that much stronger.
He was being modest. It takes a lot of work to fight and summon a dragon.
Maybe Zardus asks. Oh, go ahead.
Maybe we don't kill you then. Maybe we just leave you unable to move.
As you say that, she bites off her tongue.
Oh.
And she slowly gargles. Drowns to death in her own blood.
I was just going to smash all of the bones in her limbs, but that works, I guess.
You see her body slowly turns to dust and blows away in the wind, even though there is no wind.
Is that a door? Do we see that door that's right below me?
You do see that door, but I'd like you all to roll me perception before moving on.
Uh-huh.
Kononoko, you've clearly looked at the layout of this room, and you see that there's an alcove that seems to be missing from one side.
Ooh.
You find it very curious.
Alright, I will move here first and look for that gold that was...
You find a gold necklace bearing the symbol of one tooth.
Alright.
The Slayton seem pick
you
that up?
You can tell it's very valuable. Roll me perception, Slayton, and... John definitely knows about it, and you also seen him pick it up.
What are you doing? We're not supposed to touch anything in here.
As he says that, you feel a rumbling throughout the cavern.
Ah. Crap.
I'm going to feel around where she was.
Just before that, Kononoko, is it still in your hand, or have you put it back down?
I put it back down.
You tried to put it back down, but the chains wrapped themselves around your arm. And it's basically hanging from your forearm, and it just will not let go.
Can Zaldus go up to Kononoko and be like, hey, let me look at that, and do an arcane check on it, try to feel
sure.
it, feel out.
You can tell it's warded. It's design. Its original design was to protect the wearer, but since then, it looks like it latches on to whoever would be stealing that, and as you're clearly studying it arcanely, it actually knocks you back up the stairs and onto the dais, and you hit the altar very abruptly.
Ugh. I think that's got some bad magic on it.
I'd have to agree with you.
You have acquired a parasitic emblem.
But it's gold.
Yeah, it doesn't do anything else. It's just stuck to you. Now, back to the alcove. You've noticed that this room is not exactly symmetrical.
I will move there.
Roll me perception.
Nice.
Sorry, whose was the most recent roll?
Oh, and I'll beckon someone over to me.
It's Chris's perception roll only. Sorry.
No.
And you can choose whoever you beckoned over, or they can all come. It doesn't matter.
Did I feel anything when I felt around where she was?
You feel very slutty-looking clothing.
I'll just beckon everybody.
You can,
that makes up for everything.
you can tell the wall here was patched up after the rest of the crypt was built. It's not solid marble like everything else is. It looks to be brick and mortar, and the mortar is kind of corroded a bit with the water coming down from the surface. And there's a few cracks. In fact, you can see that it looks like there's another very dark room on the other side.
I will poke Slayton and tell him you should probably see what you can do to that wall.
What was that?
You cut out a lot.
I did?
Yeah.
Yeah. That was alien voice.
That's probably my internet, sorry.
Yeah, teach me how to do that. I'd like to do that for a character.
Well, I was working on being Mr. Smith, but, I don't know. I poke Sladen and tell him to, see if he can work on the wall a little bit.
Yeah, I, suppose I can give it a good old, 1-2 with a hammer.
Roll me strength.
Nope.
You're so drunk, you drop it.
Oh, boy.
It's too bad we had to kill her.
Anyone else would like to try with that?
Could Zardus start spamming magic missile at the wall and just try to...
Yeah, roll me Arcana.
You could probably also, like, phase shift through the wall, couldn't you?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you blast the wall apart.
Yeah.
How is your arcana?
Julian, could I search this altar over here while they're over there?
Yes, you sure can.
What, just a perception, or what would be best?
Roll me perception.
All right.
You can tell they are the bones of children. It's sickening to look at. The blood is consistent with what you've seen come from humans.
So I'm pretty sure it was the two kids. So all their flesh came off of them?
Yes, basically, it looked like they had become that aberration monster you had seen earlier that left.
I'm going to move to one of these torches. Could they be picked up?
They're pretty sturdy in the ground. You can go ahead and try to pull it if you want.
What do I roll for that?
Strength.
Well,
after a short while, it does give, but again, you feel the whole crypt rumble as that happens.
I want to set fire to the bones.
You feel rumbling again when you set fire to the bones, but it's in such a way that it's almost out of respect for the dead.
Interesting.
All right. After that, I will rejoin the others.
Okay. The rest of you guys, there is a door in front of you.
Can we listen to see if there's anything, we hear anything behind it?
You can roll perception. You hear whispers saying, "Enter."
So.
Well, looks like we're invited in, so can't be that bad, right, guys?
Sladen's probably just gonna belch, so he's pretty drunk. So.
I'll get the door then.
Okay.
Can we spend a healing surge right now? I guess, is this a short rest?
Yeah, you sure can.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll spend one to go back to 20.
You get a d6 on top of it. Unless you're...
Yeah.
And I will also...
Sorry, I'm just going to move you for a second.
No problem.
Woohoo!
22.
Very nice. There we go. Yeah, so the door opens. You see there's two fiery goblets in front of you. There's a chest, and on top of the chest you see your old friend.
I'll move to there.
I'll probably just stay
it's
in
the
back.
It's the person from the well.
Well, actually, yes. I will move
he's,
up right
he's
next to him.
Very clearly the spirit you saw earlier.
And I'll say to him, we killed all of them we found, except for the one that got away.
You have done well. Sladen, you see this golden light shoot out of the specter's mouth and enter yours, and you feel whole once again.
Woo! Plus one soul.
Yes, exactly. Don't spend it all in one place.
Yeah, so we now have two souls in the party. So.
Well, one and a half, kind of. Anyway, he says, you have done well. But he's staring now at Kononoko, and he says, my amulet. I must have it back.
I'll give it to you if it will let go of me.
It will come to the one it protects.
All right.
So it leaves your wrist, and it's... floats slowly towards him and clasps around his neck. Then he says, you've done well. I am at rest again. We are all at rest again. This treasure here was buried with me. You may have it as your reward. Thank you. And he fades away, and suddenly the creepy feeling you've been getting throughout this crypt is just gone. It now just feels like you're in an underground cavern. The chest in front of you is not locked.
So, Sladen's right in front of it, so he'll just pop the lid.
All right, inside you find 8 healing potions.
Yes.
That'll be good.
And you find 50 gold each.
We give them all to Zardus.
So 50 gold apiece.
And you each gained 200 experience.
Alrighty.
And that is all in this room. What would you like to do next?
Well, she kept trying to head for that other door. I think we should see what's back there.
Yeah.
All right. Zardus is gonna look at the party and just be like, "We can't let," and he's just gonna be like, "It get away."
Must have kind of vanished on us.
Did it go out the door,
or did it just vanished? It teleported.
Oh, never mind.
Yeah.
All right. So you go through that door. You all die instantly. No.
Oh.
Level 4. Can't be that bad.
And you see it's a very long hallway.
I guess we'll go to the other door.
Yeah, we'll go to the end of the hallway.
Okay. Alright, the door behind you slams shut and locks very loudly. But from behind the wall, you see this device stick out.
Oh, great.
And we all die.
That's not good.
When you walked into the hallway, it wasn't the regular marble like the rest of the floor. This room looks like it was dug out into dirt. And it almost looks like it was a makeshift add-on that the drow did. There's bones sticking out of the dirt. Clearly, this is through the cemetery dirt itself. But the ground looked remarkably smooth. It was just pebbly sand. But now the sand has fallen away to what looks like wooden conveyor belt slats. Oh. And they are starting to go backwards into the saw.